Obviously, I don't know, maybe a problem in the pit stop, but it's really frustrating because I think today we had the race won and I really, really wanted to win this race, you know. So it's a big team and we try our best to win. If somebody makes a mistake, it's part of the game, and no one should feel bad. We'll go to the next race.
Well, as we restart the race, incredibly, it is Keith Robinson who leads the encounter now after yet another round of pit stops. And he has the Porsche, the 41 Class 3 Porsche right behind him. That is for position. The fans absolutely enthralled by an amazing 2.5 hour endurance race. And this is the battle for production 2 honours. The Cox Ford Escort now losing out to Byford and Fagg in their Honda Accord. And this is the battle for the lead of the race. Down the inside, Callum Lockie is doing much, much better as the circuit starts to get wet once more. And Lockie dives down the inside of Keith Robinson and takes the lead of the race again. This is a sprint race. We've had 2 hours of racing already. Just nose to tail. Look, it is getting wet. The wet tyres are getting ready. Keith Robinson's brought the car in and it's sheeting down. Absolutely sheeting down. Oh, look at the conditions now. Surely safety car conditions. Oh, no. Cox Ford Escort in the very hard wall at the first corner. The Bull Run Seat, I wonder if that slick tires are a problem. And the Jones Porsche was lying second overall, and he's been in the Rockingham wall as well. Safety car conditions definitely to recover his car. What an amazing turn of events. We've got cars now taking advantage and pitting again, but it's only a short cloud burst. Oh, Callum Lockie spun the car under safety car conditions. That's how difficult it is. Lockie, an experienced driver. That's a fantastic car. And now we are restarting again with about 10 minutes remaining. Everyone queuing up behind the various production cars. And it's side by side for the lead of the race. Robinson's got ahead of Lockie under more pit stops, but they're side by side going down towards Dean. It's Callum Lockie who's taken the advantage going out of the corner. Aaron Scott has rejoined the race and recovers. Oh, but he's lost it. He's going to go round. He has gone round. There's damage to the front of the car where I think he made contact with Rafael Friantino in the 26 Marcos as Gini Uzzi recovers, and the checkered flag is out. We've got a car off around the circuit, and that means that Wick Gamski and Keith Robbins are going to take 6 out of 6 across the line. And what an incredible way to finish a 2.5 hour endurance race. There is the Seat of Blackley and Robertshaw. And therefore the result is Gamski and Robinson ahead of Lockie in second. Clark and Gibson take a production 1 win in third position overall. Then Morcillo, Cintrano, Huggins, Friantino and Fagg and Byford 6 overall and a P2 win.
Congratulations. Wit, tell us about your first stint out there. Not your favourite circuit?
No, it's not my favourite circuit. It's a very difficult circuit for the car. The car takes a long time to warm up. It's just frightening, to be honest.
Going into the first corner, turn two, Callum took it tight. And he thought I was going to go up the inside, so he defended, and I knew exactly what he was thinking. So I then pulled out and took a wide line, and he had such an acute angle to get through. He lost the rear, and I just went up the inside, and then came across this Seat and got up the inside of the Seat. And I think Callum made contact with the Seat trying to follow me through, and it brought a checkered flag out. I was not sure. I saw this checkered flag, and I thought, I've just seen the checkered flag, so I just went round again to make sure.
This car is quite difficult to drive in the wet on slicks, plus we're missing the ABS and traction control, so it was doubly tricky. So we opted to go to wets, which ultimately was the wrong thing because it dried out really quickly. So, however, with the safety cars, we about came out even with everything. The last lot of rain was crazy. That was really dangerous. We were sliding around all over the place, and there was no option but to go to wets.
Yeah, we don't have the fastest car out there, but definitely the most consistent one. So, yeah, it kept in one piece perfectly and good pace enough to be hanging in the top three, top second. So, yeah, really happy. Thank you.
Wayne, you took the first stint. How did that go for you?
It was quite all right. We lost it on the first lap. I had a bit of a spin, which put us more or less last. And then we ploughed back through the field to pull us back to fifth position.
The lads did a fantastic job in the pits. And we, in actual fact, in the pit stop, we made up a place. So it was real good teamwork. Really pleased.
So that's the end of an extremely entertaining race here at Rockingham. Congratulations go to Wick Gamski and Keith Robinson for a well-deserved win. We will see you next time for the big one. It's the 24-hour at Silverstone.
seasons in one day. Lying in the depths of your imagination, worlds above and worlds below. The sun shines on the black clouds hanging over the domain. Even when you're feeling warm, the temperature could drop away. Like four seasons in one.